Hello and welcome to my channel. Hope you are doing well. In this video, I would like to share how I created this. Before getting into the topic, I would like to thank you for being here and supporting me. If you are new to my channel, please do consider subscribing, that would be highly appreciated.
Open up After Effects and create a new composition. Name it as main. I am choosing a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and duration of 8 seconds. Create a new solid layer and name it as background. Search for fill effect from the effects and presets panel and apply it into the background layer. Choose the fill color and choose a color whatever you like. I am choosing it gray color. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in subscribe. Align the text to the center of the composition. I am changing up the background color. I need a lighter version. Create a new shape layer. Click on the rounded rectangle tool. Make the fill as no fill. Set the stroke size to 23 and create a shape around the text. Align the shape layer to the center of the composition. Name the layer as stroke. Search for fill from the effects and presets panel and apply it to the text layer and choose the color of your choice. Do the same to the stroke layer as well with the same color. Search for radial wipe from the effects and presets panel and apply it to the text layer. Set the wipe to counterclockwise. Set the wipe center to the top right corner of the composition. Create a keyframe at the start of the timeline for the transition completion of 100%. At around 3 seconds, create another keyframe with the transition completion with 0%. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Select the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now ramp preview this. Select the text layer and duplicate them twice. Offset the duplicated text layers. And change the colors of the text using the fill color. I'm trying to offset it some more, but it's looking too slow, so I am coming back to the older version. I'm offsetting the two layers to around 6 seconds. In the stroke layer, go to contents in that rectangle one. In the rectangle one, choose stroke one. Create a keyframe for stroke width at 5 second mark. And go to the start of the timeline and set the stroke width value to 0. Now RAM preview this. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Click on the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. Select the line cap to round cap. In the contents, select add and choose trim paths. In the trim paths, set the start value to 100%. Create a keyframe at 5 second mark. At 3 second mark, create a keyframe and set the start value to 0. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Click on the graph editor and change the graph as shown. I am setting the offset value to around 120 degrees. That's looking nice. Select the stroke layer and duplicate it twice and offset the two stroke layers as that of the text layer. As we have done earlier to the text layer, change the color of the stroke layers respective to that of the text layers. Now RAM preview this. That's looking nice. I'm offsetting the three text layers so that the trim path effect and the radial whip effect coincides. Now RAM preview this. That's looking better. Create a new null object. Select all the layers except the null and background and parent it to the null layer. At the start of the timeline, select the scale property and create a keyframe and set the value to 125%. At the 45 frame mark, set the scale value back to 100. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. Select all the layers except the background layer. Right click and select pre-compose and name the composition as text animation. Duplicate the pre-compose layer. Search for drop shadow from the effects and presets panel and apply it to the below lying layer. Search for fill from the effects and presets panel and apply it to the same layer. Change the fill layer to black and bring down the drop shadow effect below the fill effect. Set the opacity value to 100. set the distance to 10 and softness to 50. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's looking better. That's it. Hope you enjoyed this video.
The music used in this video is from No Copyright Sounds. I will leave a link in the description. If you want the track, you can check that out. That's it. I hope you liked this video. If you have enjoyed this video, consider subscribing. I will leave a link in the description. Also hit that like button and share it with your friends. Also, if you have anything to say, please feel free to comment down below. Once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. Thanks for watching. Stay safe. This is Raudran signing off.